smokes and he tells dirty jokes. Here's to the bus driver with us today.
God bless him, he needs it.
God bless him,
he needs it.
Here's to the bus driver with us today. Here's to the bus driver.
June 27th. Dear Diary. At least I hope talking into a tape recorder can be considered a diary. Well, anyway, here I am on my way to camp. And these kids have been singing ever since we got on the bus.
8.5 hours on a bus. Might as well be going to the moon.
Camp North Pines must be really north.
Where we're supposed to be, are we there yet? Is this the
runner? Hey, Mr. Caldwell.
Peter says he has to go to the bathroom again.
Just relax, Peter. We'll be there soon.
Not soon enough.
Come on.
Okay, guys, listen. Everybody wants to play football? Put your bags over there and come over here and line up.
You guys
come on, guys.
Hurry up.
Come on.
You have an extra toothbrush.
Come on, guys. Come on. Okay, eight. Come on here. Circle. Okay. Okay. Split in half right here. Come on, let's go. Let's go.
Let's go.
Attention campers, welcome to Camp North Pines.
Please check your camp assignments and camp schedule and have a great summer.
Attention campers, welcome to North Pines, where we got lots of soul and rock and roll and wild time.
Okay, boys, this is home. You got your beds here. You got pillows in the corner that don't have too much fun.
Hello, boys.
Where's the football field?
Archery. Swimming. Girls.
Ooh, how sweet it is.
Yeah, but that's really sweet.
You know it.
Hey, get out of that tree.
Okay. Two-hand touch. I got it. Oh, shit. So the bottom line is, here I am at camp, just where I didn't want to be. But now that I'm here, I might as well make the best of it. Uh-oh, trouble.
Hey, kid, it's cabin cleaning time. Let's go. Hey, what's that, a tape recorder?
It's a computer. It analyzes people's personality from voice patterns.
Oh, yeah? Hey, do me.
Okay. Just tell it your name, age, and why you came to camp.
My name's Stanley Runk. My friends call me Runk the Punk, and I'm a CIT. That means counselor in training. And if this don't work, your ass is grass.
Please tell us Mr. Rung's basic personality.
You're a giant purple dork.
Come out, guys, come out.
Hey, making easy odds for yourself, huh, Stanley?
The name's Runk. Runk the Punk.
Oh, that's cute. Look, Donald's in my cabin. So let him go.
Stay out of my face, small crap.
Don't worry about Donald.
Man, that guy's a real pug.
Attention campers, it's time for lunch. Everyone to the mess hall.
Hi. Who's the butterfly guy?
That's Mr. Warren. He's the new camp director. Some kind of a nature freak.
He looks pretty freaky to me.
What you doing, mister?
Oh, this is my butterfly collection, son.
Peter, this is Mr. Warren.
Hello, Franklin. That's a nice group of boys you've got there.
Yeah, they're not bad for a bunch of brats.
Aww.
Peter, I wanted to share my butterfly collection with the whole camp.
Come on, guys. Mr. Warren can show the collection to us later.
Yes, in fact, if you'd like, I'll take you on a butterfly hunt after lunch.
Did you do these guns?
No, Peter. I think Nets will be safe.
Come on, guys. Let's go.
And hear our thanks for this day and for the bountiful nourishment we are about to receive. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Let's chow down. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Rowdy bunch. Hope we can depend on the junior counselors or CITs, whatever you call them.
I guess we have no choice. We're cutting government funds. We're lucky to have four counselors this year.
Where did they get this guy, Alcatraz?
All right, fellas, let's hold it down. You all know me. I'm Ed Hines. This is Jack Caldwell, our sports director. But now I'd like to introduce our new camp director, Mr. Warren. And since this is his first time with us this year, let's show him how attentive we can be.
As you just heard, this is my first year.
I know. This guy used to be principal of Braxton High.
And I look forward to our association.
That must be a real schnazzy, huh?
Boys, we're going to have a wonderful time this summer. But first, I'd like to explain the rules. There'll be no swearing.
What?
And of course, no cigarettes or alcoholic beverages. Now, due to the drastic cutback in funds, we have less counselors this year, but there are still plenty of activities.
Oh, we got TV. I'm missing Dallas.
We got TV here in the rec hall, but we didn't come all this way to watch TV.
Because of the sex and violence on TV.
First thing Warren does, I've taken Jerry rigs the TV so only gets one channel.
Yeah? 26.
Which one? You know, the one with all that religion.
Find it in life.
He says it's good for our souls.
Besides, it's good for your souls.
What? Oh, man.
I've also set aside one of the buildings as a meditation center where you can voluntarily spend some quiet time or where you'll be sent if you violate any of the rules.
Meditation center? What does he think this is, a state pen?
And one more thing. The rope bridge, it's off limits for two reasons. One, it leads directly to the girls' camp. Yeah! And two, it's very unsafe and can be used only for emergencies.
I ain't gonna see my girlfriend all summer. I got an emergency right here.
In conclusion, I'd like to say that I'm sure this will be a very memorable summer.
The
It's like Franklin's got him hypnotized.
Yeah.
Man, I thought the dude got brought to the bus in a limousine.
Big bucks.
Yeah, I heard his father wanted him to see exactly how the other half lives.
It's okay with me. Come on, Ann.
And to prove his worth, he brought his brother's severed head, still dripping with blood, back to the province and laid it at the king's feet. And for this, he was knighted and granted forgiveness.
Are you boys ready for the hunt?
Yeah!
Franklin, we meet you back here at 4 o'clock. All right, let's go.
Butterflies, what a fruit.
Really?
Not bad for a Stanley.
Wrong.
Whatever. Thank
you. If this bridge weren't busted, we'd be right in the girls' camp.
Hey, what you doing?
Just testing one of my theories.
Yeah, what's that?
That society keeps us in line by the use of fear.
Huh?
When we overcome fear, Stanley, that's when we stand above society.
Oh, come on, anybody can cross that thing.
Oh, yeah?
Whoa! Careful.
I'll do it if you'll do it. Is that a no?
No, that's a you're crazy, man. Is he really gonna do that?
Why, just because you're too scared?
Drunk.
What?
Shut up.
What the hell were you trying to do? You could have killed yourself.
Just a little test of valor, sir.
Well, save the valor for military school. This is summer camp, okay?
Yes, sir.
Not bad.
That puppy.
For an uptown boy.
June 28th, dear diary. Mr. Warren decided we should all go swimming every day, which is fine, except I feel funny because I never learned how to swim. I noticed Franklin Riley's not swimming either, but I can't believe it's because he doesn't know how.
Come on, let's swim.
Me?
Yeah, come on, let's swim.
No, I can't swim.
Well, I'll teach you how to swim. Come on.
No, Bob, what the heck?
Ho. Huh?
Your glasses?
Oh.
Yeah.
Now swim. No, wait, hold on. Stand there. You gotta go like this. Watch my arms.
Hey, Donald, looks like you got a rash there.
No, it's okay, honest.
Yeah, come on, pal. That don't look too good. Could be poison oak. Be right back.
Okay, well, come on. Now stretch out. Stretch out. Now paddle.
Okay.
Swim now.
Boy, that's one duck for sure can't swim.
Hi.
Door sounds good.
Yeah, isn't it great?
I got a kid down here with a rash. Just thinking about you. How you doing?
That is one tasty chick.
That's Nurse Newman. She must have drove up from the girls' camp.
I love it.
Hey, Donald, come out here and let Nurse Newman see that rash.
No way.
Donald, come out here right now.
See you in a second.
one to move. Oh, it's just a heat rash. On your way.
Sorry to put you through that.
Maybe I should come every morning, right?
Well, you haven't seen a woman in a while.
Okay. I'm gonna get my bat.
I'm okay.
You all right?
What happened?
Just doing your job for you, sir.
Good going, guy. Hi, guys. Hey, Peter. How was the butterfly hunt? Hey, kid, what happened? A butterfly bite you or something?
No.
What's with the tears? Oh, a cat got your tongue? Hey. It's your old buddy Frank. Come on, listen, if any of the kids are picking on you, just tell me who it is and I'll just give them a karate chop. Ha!
Mr. Warren.
Mr. Warren what?
Nothing.
Well, he didn't hurt you, did he?
No.
Then why the tears?
When I couldn't reach the butterflies, he kept lifting me up and holding me. I got scared. I had an accident.
Hey, Franklin, what's happening?
Come here. Listen, Stanley. From what Peter just told me, I think Mr. Warren may be more of a fruit than we thought.
What? You mean Mr. Warren? Oh, goddamn.
Just take it easy, Stanley. Let me handle this.
Yeah. Sure, whatever you say.
Good. Peter, now you better change your clothes, and we won't tell anybody about this at all, will we? Good. Now, let me see a big smile. Come on. Now, use your pawns to help slow down an offensive attack.
Pawns?
Yeah. 30 more fun-filled days. I don't know if I can stand the excitement.
In front of this very congregation,
yeah.
Did repent of his sins and rise up out of his wheelchair, a healed man.
See, with just one clever move, you can instantly annihilate an evil force. Checkmate.
Incredible. Amazing,
Franklin. How can you guys watch this stuff?
It ain't easy.
Look, I don't have anything against religion, but are you gonna let Mr. Warren censor what we watch all summer long?
You got a better idea?
Hey, Runk says you're some kind of electronical whiz.
I mess around with it a little.
We'll see if you can come mess around with this television.
I guess I could. Oh, if it wasn't on the roof, but heights freaked me out, so I don't...
It's okay. We'll get somebody to go up on the roof if heights bother you.
Sure. Someone will go up.
Yeah. Chris will go with you.
Thanks a lot. Come on, Doug.
That breastplate. Because God's love and God's cleansing light can come into your life today. And my friends.
Wait till everything stops spinning.
It's not a second.
Okay. All right. Now hand me the screwdriver.
Friends, that he will never walk the earth again. To save the souls of all the lost and denied sinners of Babylon that walk among us.
Well, we're still saving sinners in here.
Come on, Doc. They're still saving sinners.
Yes, Brother Dave, I want to fight ungodliness. I want to fight.
Got it.
Yeah! Oh, mama, shake that groovy thing.
This is total disregard for the rules. The television will stay off. And I'm closing down this rec hall right now.
Oh, come on! Give us a break!
All right!
Mission accomplished.
And you two can report directly to the meditation center.
Come on, Mr. Warren, isn't that a little severe? I mean, they're just having a little fun.
The matter's not open for discussion.
Come on, Mr. Warren, we're just a bunch of horny guys.
Oh, no. No, you're just a bunch of obnoxious little boys.
You wish we were little boys.
What did you say? All right. Out of here right now, all of you.
Mr. Warren kept us in what everyone now calls the pen all the next day. Luckily, he let us out just as the bus from the girls' camp arrived for the talent show.
Tell him he's cute. I'll tell him tomorrow night. I'll ask him to dance. Are
these guys always so distracted?
Come on, girls. Let's move along, please. And, yes, they are.
My name is Hammond, tonight's DJ, so I want you to dig what I have to say. This talent show is gonna blow your lids, so put your hands together for putting on the kid. Friends, Romans, and countrymen too, there's a little something I gotta tell you. They will make your hair frizzle, will make your fingers blister, so put your hands together for the South Park sisters.
Must be bored here at North Pines. There's only so much you can do. Come visit us, the girls down at South Pines. We'll see that all your dreams come true. Okay, but this be so cool. Come visit us and you live with us at our pool. Down south, down south. I'll fix you up a snack. I'll rub your tired back.
If you're a real good boy, I'll even share my sack.
Down south. So boys, you'll find it's worth the tramp. We're lighting up the lamp. Hurry or you'll stand in line. Stop wasting all this precious time. Come visit us at Camp South Pines. Down south, South Pines. Down south. Come visit us at Camp South Pines.
Enough.
Yeah.
I gotta ride the buggy right here.
Can you say what you're saying? Okay, let's go. Let's do it.
And now, for our next act, the one and only.
Heather, did you see that guy in the front row? He was
Slick and straight.
No, he wasn't. Yes, he was.
Oh,
he was.
Beat
came
with a dark hair.
Oh,
he was eyeing you down. He was totally eyeing you down.
Pretty stupid, huh?
Pretty,
but not stupid.
And
what's your name?
Trixie.
Well, what kind of tricks do you do?
Mm-hmm. This is Debbie.
Ooh, Debbie. I'm on fire, baby.
What's your name?
Heather.
Thank you, Manuel. That was great. Now, for our next act, you're gonna love them. Okay. The group of guys have been working for a long, long time. I think you're gonna find them fine as wine. They're as good for you as a morning jog. So put your hands together for the horn dogs.
Should be ashamed of yourselves acting like that in front of young children. Ladies, I'm afraid I must please ask you to file into the buses and return to Camp South Pines immediately. And I'm afraid to say the dance planned for this weekend will have to be canceled.
What a gonad!
All right, girls, let's go. You heard what he said. Come along.
Come on.
Everybody.
With this dick in charge, I'm not going to meet a girl all summer.
Oh, I wouldn't be too sure about that.
Ooh, ooh. Ooh, ooh. Ooh, ooh.
Is that you, John?
Mason, you're a goddamn genius.
I told you.
Come here.
Oh, ladies, I would like you to meet Runk the Punk.
Ooh, looks more like Runk the Hunk to me.
Do it. Oh, no. I love it when you talk like that. Say screwing. It again.
Maniac man, come on, let's go.
Chris, yeah. I just hope this isn't going to be another one of those summer romances, you know?
You mean I'm not the first?
Oh, come on. You know what I mean.
Yeah, I know what you mean. This is really hard for me to tell you how much I like you. Words and...
Maybe actions are better than words.
What on earth? This is the Arts and Crafts Center. What are you doing?
Mrs. Knut, this is Christopher Wayne.
Hi.
You'd better come with me.
Kids were about to lynch Mr. Warren when he announced he was sending Chris home as soon as the next bus went for supplies. When he said we wouldn't be seeing the girls again all summer, well, that's when Franklin had Runk call some of the guys together for a meeting.
What are we doing out here in the middle of the night? The only thing not sleeping out here is us.
Yeah, well, Franklin said it was important. I wouldn't be here on old Runk the asshole punk says.
Who are you calling an asshole?
That could have killed me.
Only if I missed. Oh, what's the matter, puss? No one to hide behind with Chris in the pen?
Take it easy, Stanley. All right, listen up. We've got to do something about Warren.
What do you mean?
What do I mean? Look, I don't know about you, but I came here to have some fun. As long as Warren's in charge, that's just not going to be possible. He's already done away with the dance and with the talent show. Pretty soon, the only thing we'll be doing are having butterfly hunts. And then he goes and locks up a really nice guy like Chris.
Yeah, and besides, he's a goddamn...
Shut up, Stanley!
But Franklin...
Just shut up. So, some of us have been talking and we've decided to take over the camp.
Are you guys local? You're just gonna get a lot of us in trouble.
Nobody's gonna get in trouble because nobody's gonna get hurt.
Yeah, it's gonna be a bloodless coup.
I mean that, Rivas. I mean, just think of it as another camp game, a game like...
Like capture the flag?
Exactly. Donald, I knew you were a smart kid. Now come on up here. I'm counting on you, Donald Poultry. I want you to be the first kid to join the revolution. Blackridge.
Count me in.
Runk.
Yep.
Mason.
Damn right.
You'll have the rank of captain. Are you with us, Captain Donald Poultry?
Good morning, campers and counselors, and welcome to today, Camper Counselor Turnabout Day. As you know, this is our annual event where campers become counselors and counselors become campers.
I can't wait to meet you.
you remember to brush your teeth, Junior?
Rub-a-dub-dub. Thanks for the grub. Amen and hallelujah. Let's chow down.
Yeah!
All right, fellas, settle down. You all know me. I'm Ed Hines. Mr. Warren here has some announcements to make.
Mr. Warren?
Thanks, Mr. Hines. You are a fine example of what a black man can do if given the right opportunity in a white supremacist society. From now on, all of you shall address me as your king, master of the universe. I shall abolish all nature walks and butterfly hunts. The wake-up call will be changed from 7 a.m. Well, to whenever the hell you want, okay?
And no more quiet meditation hour.
King Ham, please, no more push-ups.
Oh. Yeah. Hey, no more bratty kids. Oh.
My beloved peons, I have time to grant but one more request.
Free Chris Wayne. Free Chris Wayne. Free Chris Wayne.
Free Chris Wayne.
Free Chris Wayne.
Free Chris Wayne.
Free Chris Wayne.
Free Chris Wayne.
Free Chris Wayne.
Free Chris Wayne.
The campers have spoken!
Free Chris Wayne.
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 Come on, let's go, man.
Come on, let's go, man.
Chris.
All right, that's enough. The game's over. I knew from the beginning I should have sent you troublemakers home. Caldwell, grab those keys. Put these delinquents in there.
Hold it!
Mr. Warner should be locked up, not us.
What are you talking about?
Why don't you tell him about the butterfly hunt, Mr. Warren? Yeah, Peter told me what you did to him.
What I did to him?
Goddamn pervert! You know, I knew it. He's always playing up to the little kids.
I've had enough of this.
Come on, Franklin, use your head. You're in enough trouble as it is.
Hold it right there, Hines. Blackridge. Open the door. Now, Mr. Warren, in the pen. You let us get in there, too. I mean it. Move.
Better do as he says.
Thank you.
Blackridge, guard the door.
All right, man, where'd you go?
Okay, Runk, Mason, go get those guys with the tools and board up the windows.
Oh, I got you.
Frankly, you can't do this.
Do what?
Take the law into your own hands.
Come on, Chris, I just made a citizen's arrest. After what he did to Peter?
Well, that's what you think. Let's call the cops.
We'll call the cops. Let's have a little fun first.
Fun?
Come on, Chris, you're a team player. We'll call the cops tomorrow.
What now, General O'Reilly?
We have a lot of work ahead of us. That is, if Chris here doesn't mind.
What's wrong?
You wouldn't understand. Donald?
Which is it, Donald?
Well, you did save my life.
Okay. Let's go round up the rest of the counselors.
Am I getting this right, Captain Poetry, sir?
We shall soon see, Lieutenant Pumpernail.
Attention, North Pines campers. This is General Franklin Riley speaking. I would like to announce a new twist to Turnabout Day.
The campers have held a revolution, freed Chris Wayne, and now all the counselors are in the pen. Yeah! As you can well imagine, we have some good times in store for us.
And just to kick things off, here are a few announcements. Jerome Blackridge has been named head of the Revolutionary Police. That means you guys have to listen to what he says. You got it? Stanley Runk and John Mason have also been made officers. And there will be more appointments for those who cooperate.
Party time. It's a bunch of crap in here. Bingo!
And what have you?
Now, the whole idea of this revolution is to have fun. More fun than you've ever had in your whole lives.
So sit back and relax, because we're going to have fun with a capital F.
We got some liquor.
Well, well, my father's brand.
Hello, Captain Rothbard. Oh, Mr. Warren. Well, he's tied up right now. Uh-huh. Oh, sure. Okay. I don't take messages.
10-year-olds are such a paradox. They claim they hate boys, but that's all they talk about.
That's all the whole camp's been talking about since Mr. Warren called a halt to the socials.
Well, we'll just have to find more healthy activities for our young ladies.
Honestly, Mrs. Canute, boys are a healthy activity.
Well, it is getting rather late, and we do have an early wake-up tomorrow. Beth, would you see who that is, please? What are you boys doing here? Something wrong? Where's Mr. Warren?
Pardon me, ladies, but we're having a revolution over at Camp North Pines. And we've decided to include the girls' camp in with it.
Well, if this is some kind of a joke, it's not funny, and I suggest you leave this instant.
Don't be alarmed, but Stanley here has something he'd like to show you. Show her, Stanley. Now, we're serious, Mrs. Canute. Now, I want you to give me your keys. And I want one of you to show me where the cook sleeps. Right now.
Hey, Gogo, mine's looking pretty good. How about yours?
Let's see. Oh, mine's got a paint-by-numbers face.
Hey, girls, looks like it's your lucky day.
Let's go.
Come on.
All right, let's jam.
Yeah, may the force be with us. Hey, guys, come on.
What do you guys think you're doing?
Good morning, all you lovely young ladies of Camp South Pine.
This is Franklin Riley, leader of the revolution. And I'm here to tell you that we have just liberated your camp. Have a nice day.
Hey, girls, it's breakfast time.
Breakfast.
All right.
know that I wonder if you could hear.
Say it's time we had to see how this place is run.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And keeping girls and guys apart is ridiculous. Yeah. So I say that we're going to have our annual co-ed dance tonight. Right. Now, if you're wondering what happened to your counselors, well, they've taken a short vacation. Yeah. Don't worry, they'll be back when the party's over. It's just like camper counselor turnabout day.
Come on, what is this? What are you trying to pull? Who died and left you, boss?
That's cool, Franklin. That's Debbie. Debbie, come up here. Come on. Come on!
Now, we've already worked this out at North Pines, and I've talked to Mrs. Canute and assured her that this is all in fun. And in fact, right after this, we're meeting with her again to iron out all the details. Debbie, maybe I could ask you to be acting director. How's that?
Do it.
Okay, I guess.
Okay, where's Doreen Larson?
Right here, and it's Trixie.
All right, Trixie, would you come up here, please? Now, Trixie, you'll be in charge of party arrangements, and both you and Debbie will be on the Supreme Revolutionary Committee.
Sounds good to me.
Okay, then it's party time at Camp North Pines tonight!
Come on, Chris, I want to be with you. This isn't right.
Let's just wait one more day. Franklin swears he's gonna call off in the morning, okay?
I, Franklin Riley.
I, John Mason.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
To be loyal and faithful.
To be loyal and faithful.
To the Revolution Party.
To the Revolution Party!
And not to betray the Revolution or its leaders!
And not to betray the Revolution or its leaders!
To any outsiders!
To any outsiders!
For as long as the Revolution lives!
For as long as the Revolution lives!
To the Revolution!
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 To the Revolution! To the Revolution! To the Revolution! To the Revolution!
It was amazing how Franklin got everyone to go along with the revolution. He made it all like a game. Well, of course, a party seemed like a lot more fun than a butterfly hunt.
This is turning out really neat. I don't feel like a kid anymore.
Doing? Putting a little life in the party.
Let's get crazy! Woo!
girl is hot. Let's get these kids out of here. Come on, come on. Blake?
Wait a minute, man. What the hell? Snake right out from under.
I want to turn your life upside down. Come to think of it, I'd like to turn you upside down. I'm not kidding.
Promises, promises.
You know.
Hey, it's mating season. What's the matter? Can't you find a girl buck anywhere?
Ha, ha, ha. What a cracker. I'll leave him alone. He's kind of cute.
Hear that, Duck? She thinks you're cute. Want to stand in for me?
It's not that cute.
Yeah, well, you're no major babe yourself.
What do you think Warren would think about this?
You freak out. You totally freak out.
Who goes there, friend or foe?
This is Vietnam.
Yeah, you, John?
Who's it look like to you? Now, where's Warren?
Inside. Why?
Miss Franklin wants him, okay?
Okay.
Thanks.
What the hell is going on?
Don't worry about it. So, Mr. Warren, how do you like the new summer camp?
He looks like a party animal to me, doesn't he?
Come on, let's get some music. Hey, this is the party, right? Let's have some tunes.
She carries on and on until she's satisfied. Her needs are filled. She ripples while she's standing still.
I think she likes older men.
I think you're right.
Alright, that's enough. Hey, come on, we're just trying to have some fun. Some fun. Up yours, Chris.
Thank you, Chris. Now listen to me. If you release all of us right now, no one will be punished.
And up yours too, Warren.
Have you all lost your senses? What you're doing is sinful. Think of the consequences.
Runk, take Mr. Warren back to the pen.
What you're doing is sinful.
Just get him the hell out of here, Rug.
Come on, Chris, let's talk.
You're going back to the pen, you pervert.
Oh, my God.
is all wrong, Franklin. I'm not gonna have anything to do with it.
Then don't. Play house with Heather, babysit the brats. Just stay out of our way, or you'll be in the pen with Warren. Keep an eye on him till he cools off.
Yes, sir, General Riley.
Franklin, look, I don't know how to tell you this. Mason and me, we were only joking. Okay. I was walking him back. Warren's dead.
What?
He's dead. It was an accident. A total accident. I mean, he fell on my knife. I didn't mean to do it. Honest. I mean, he's just lying out there behind cabin three. Dead. Franklin!
Just shut up and let me think! Okay, Stanley. Listen very carefully. Go get Blackridge and take Mr. Warren's body back into the woods. Take him to the caves by the river. Do you understand? Put him deep into those caves and don't say anything to anyone. Got it?
Yeah, I got it.
Okay, then report back here to me after you're finished. We'll just tell everybody that we transferred him to the girls' camp. Stanley, from now on, you do exactly as I say. Do you understand?
Attention campers, this is General Franklin Riley. The revolution is not over yet.
Now, for those of you who work for the revolution, who show loyalty, who show courage, who show dedication,
those people will become officers and members of the Supreme Revolutionary Committee. As an example, I want to single out Colonel Donald Poultry, who has been made Minister of Propaganda, and who I am now appointing to the Supreme Revolutionary Committee. Now, there may be some among us who choose not to go along.
And I'm sorry to say this, but Chris Wayne and Heather Lund have been caught trying to betray the revolution. These people should be shunned. Anyone caught speaking to them will be considered traitors and lose the respect and approval of the Supreme Revolutionary Committee. This is General Franklin Riley signing off.
How you doing, guy? Doc, can I talk to you a second?
Yeah. Okay. Hand me the
Doc, what's going on around here?
Come on. Everyone's acting like we don't even exist.
Oh. Doc, are you okay?
Are you going to the party tonight?
Yeah.
You are?
Well, sure, I'm on the Supreme Revolutionary Committee.
Did you talk to Franklin? Is he really as far out as they say he is? Did he really save your life? And do you dance?
Let's see. Yes. Yes. Sort of, and no, I don't dance.
I took dancing lessons all year, and I really like it. And none of these boys will dance. Maybe I could teach you.
Maybe you could.
Good, then that's settled. I'm in sixth. How about you?
Seventh. But it's a special study for advanced electronic studies.
Oh, good. You're not one of those dumb, good-looking guys. You're a smart, good-looking guy.
All right, who's done with the postcards General Riley wanted you to write?
I'm not yet.
Maybe. Dear Mom and Dad, camp is fun. I have a pine cone collection. I miss my dog kissing for me. Love, Davey. All right, good job. Let's see, Peter. Dear Mom, we're having a real-life revolution with guns and knives and boys and girls sleeping together and everything. It's the best camp ever. Love, Peter. Here. Say what? Just copy Davey's, all right?
I got the figure in the corner.
Yahoo! Yeah!
You got him! You got him! Come on! Come on! I can't believe it!
Thomas got one. Ah, yeah!
Ooh. Listen, why don't you guys go make something with the boss? Just make something big. Something you can pick up. Go, 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 go!
Ow! Oh, I got it!
Who needs a butterfly collection anyhow?
I know, really. What a sadistic thing to do.
Come on, guys. Give a hand. Carry on.
Aren't you supposed to kill it first?
How am I supposed to know? What difference does it make? It's gonna die anyway.
Come on. Oh. Let's go for a walk. Let's go for a walk.
Sure.
Okay.
Let's go.
It's hot in
here. His name's Don. He's really cute and he wants to look. Is that here? He's really cute. Lori?
Hi. I guess it's time for my dance lesson.
Didn't think it would be like this.
Yeah, it's getting kind of X-rated around here.
Why don't we just go for a walk?
Great idea.
I walk better than I dance anyhow.
John, stop it.
You're just a rotten little tease, aren't you?
Look, ow, you're hurting me. You... Stop it!
I think there's caves around here somewhere.
Caves? How scary.
I'll protect you. Mr. Hines brought us up here on a hike once. They're around here somewhere.
Cute. What stinks?
God, that's awful.
Smells like the elephants came here to die.
Smells more like they came here to crap.
Tunnels.
What the?
Come
deploy this when you're ready. I think it's coming from down here.
Without Mr. Warren in charge, none of the kids knew what to do about Debbie and John Mason. But Franklin said he'd see that justice was carried out.
Okay.
Hey, aren't you pushing this revolution crap a little far?
Revolution crap? Don't you push me, John. You're in enough trouble as it is.
The prisoner, John Mason, stands accused by one Debbie Stewart on the night of July 1 in the vicinity of Camp North Pines for having committed the act of rape. Now, how pleads the defendant?
Huh?
The defendant, that's you. How do you plead? Debbie says you raped her. Now, did you or didn't you?
No way.
You're a liar!
He did! You are so dumb!
He did!
He did!
He did!
He did!
Quiet!
He did!
Excuse me, Franklin, but why don't we just ask John exactly what did happen?
Okay.
I asked Debbie to go for a walk with me in the woods, and she said sure. So we went. I didn't force her.
Yeah, but you forced me later.
Oh, come on. You were going along with everything, and you know it.
You bastard. Ask them if I was going along with everything.
No, she was screaming.
And don't all women make those kind of noises when they're having a good time? Besides, you'd have to lock 50 guys up if you put me away. There's a lot of this kind of stuff going on around here. Listen, Franklin. I'm innocent.
Okay, Debbie. What do you want us to do with him?
Kill him.
Oh, yeah. Right.
What?
Debbie, please.
Kill him. All right, what do you want me to say? Give him a detention? He raped me! And I say he deserves to die, and if you don't want to hear it, then quit asking me.
Okay, take him back to the administration building. I'm going to think about this, and I'll give you my decision tomorrow.
Everyone knows by now what Franklin's decision was. He calls it trial by ordeal. He says they practiced it in medieval times. Mason's got to cross the rope bridge hand over hand. If he makes it, that proves his innocence. And if not, well, that's his punishment. Doesn't make much sense to me, but Franklin seems to have everyone convinced around here. Everyone, that is, except John Mason.
Okay, Stanley.
I got a better place for you to stick the knife, Runk.
Go ahead, John. I did it, remember?
You're twisted.
I suggest you get on with this right now.
What do you think I am, pussy? Well, that's a bunch of baloney. And speaking of baloney, all you women can just bite my beef baloney, okay? Enjoy.
Thank you.
Ta-da!
All right, justice has been done!
You call that justice? That's bullshit!
Debbie, what do you want? You want me to tell everybody I raped you? And then I'd have to tell them what a lousy little lady you are?
Come on, get him! Get
I couldn't believe my eyes. Those girls picked him up and carried him off like an army of ants would carry a crust of bread. And it's weird, because no one's seen John Mason since. And the really scary thing is, no one seems to care. It's difficult to realize what's happened in just a few days. Everyone does exactly what Franklin says. Besides, most of the time, they're too partied out to even care.
It's July the 2nd.
People are starting to act really weird.
You know, I think Franklin's putting something in their Kool-Aid.
Did you say something, Duck?
Have you seen Chris Wayne lately?
Last I saw him, he was out camping in the woods with Heather.
Thanks. Chris! 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 Chris!
What the? North Pines call. We're in trouble. Can anyone hear me? Can anyone hear me?
I hear you, Duck.
Let me go. Stop it. Hey, let me go. Leave me alone. I'm gonna
Franklin,
fall.
Franklin, run. Come out of here.
Leave me alone.
That's smart,
leave
that
me,
kid.
Leave me alone. Please.
Found a duck up on the roof.
Leave me alone. Please.
You're going down.
Oh, I never trusted this kid.
No,
give him to me.
I'm gonna fall. Ow!
Come on.
All right, what's going on?
Duck is trying to reach out and touch someone.
Did he get through?
I doubt it. All I heard was static.
Take him inside.
I heard you calling.
What happened?
Mason's dead. The girls helped him.
What?
I said they hung him. He's out on the old path.
Blackridge, go check it out.
Take it easy with him.
Butt out.
You in there?
Chris?
Yeah, how do I get in?
The key is on the ledge above the door.
put it there.
Doc.
Chris!
Hey, turn that frown upside down, Doc.
Chris, I'm so glad that you're...
Look, Doc, listen, don't worry about it.
I feel so dumb. I don't even know why I went along with it.
Listen, Doc, I had a long talk with Peter about what happened in the woods with Mr. Warren.
And?
Peter said Mr. Warren never molested him.
You mean Franklin just made it all up?
Yeah, there's no way to confirm it, though. Nobody's seen Warren. Could be dead.
And I'm gonna be next. Franklin's gonna make me cross that rope bridge. And I'm not gonna make it. I'm gonna be a pile of goose at the bottom of that canyon.
Shh. Just stay down for a second. Now, come here. You just tell me where the toolkit is.
Good luck. They're still up on the roof.
Okay, I'll get them. How do I tap the wires?
See, that's where I blew it. You have to go farther away from the camp, to the main gate. Here's what you gotta do. Listen, this isn't gonna work. Why don't you just get me out of here and I'll do it?
Just what in the hell are you doing in here?
Just trying to make Doc feel a little better.
He can feel better after he crosses the bridge tomorrow. Now get the hell out of here!
It's okay.
Franklin! 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 Franklin!
Where's Chris?
He went to get help. Franklin,
Franklin, we can't wait.
Franklin,
you.
Here is the latest decree of the Supreme Revolutionary Committee. The mess hall will be open 24 hours a day.
We're gonna stop them.
Okay.
Fix whatever you want.
Come on, you guys, get ready.
Sure, we'll help.
The revolution is not over yet. It's not over because I promised you more
than
you
ever had. He's over there. Just wait till Revis gives the signal.
Now we have some serious business to take care of. The traitor, Donald Poultry, stands accused of counter-revolutionary activity.
Great.
His punishment is to cross the rope bridge.
No way, Franklin. I'm not gonna do it.
Oh, yes, you are. Get him out there, Runk.
Come on. Come on.
Hand over hand,
hey,
Donald.
Come on. I'm gonna fall. Please. Please, Runk. I'm gonna fall. Hey, stop that.
Cut the rope, Runk.
No! Don't!
Hold it, Franklin. Your revolution's over.
But not Chris.
Get out of my way, Franklin.
Stop ruining everything and just back off. That's better.
Now!
Get
Grandma.
Chris.
I got you. Hang on.
Lucky you didn't get killed.
I know that even if Chris gets through, it's gonna take 5 hours for help to get here. But here they come to take me to the bridge.
That's the last of it. But I think you get the idea of what happened, sir.
We're going to keep this for a while.
Okay. What about us?
You two can get on the bus with most of the other kids.
Good. I'm bushed.
I'd like to have the tapes when you're done with them.
We'll see about that.
Just a little keepsake, you know?
Okay, you kids can go. Go on. You tell me what happened.
Well, they kept us in a pen, but it was only a few of them.
Well, the ringleaders are in the car, and you can go on outside. Go on.
Oh, get out of here. Get on the bus.
Okay, get out of here.
It's on the ride.
All right.
Come on, guys, get on the bus.
We've located your parents in Europe, and they'll be arriving in a couple of days. Won't that be nice?